हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू थर्ड लेक्चर ऑफ जियो टेक्निकल इंजीनियरिंग। नाउ इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव सीन द ओरिजिन ऑफ सॉइल, देन जियोलॉजिकल साइकिल एंड हाउ द सॉइल इज फॉर्म्ड। नाउ इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल सी द स्कोप ऑफ सॉइल इंजीनियरिंग। नाउ वी ऑलरेडी नो दैट सॉइल इंजीनियरिंग हैज वास्ट एप्लीकेशन इन द कंस्ट्रक्शन एंड वेरियस सिविल इंजीनियरिंग वर्क। ओके, नाउ the some of the important applications of soil engineering in a civil engineering is as follows, that is our the scope of soil engineering. Now what are those applications where the soil engineering is more used? Now the in a construction phase of foundation and pre post construction phase of foundation, the scope of soil engineering is very important. Now in foundation there are just we will see about foundation first. Every structure has to be founded in or on the surface of earth, right? So therefore it is necessary to know that the bearing capacity of soil, the pattern of stress distribution in that soil, then the loaded area, then settlement of foundation in that soil. Because of the whole structure, the load of whole structure, the foundation may be get settled in your soil. That settlement of foundation, that you have to know that, right? Then effect of vibrations and groundwater table. In ground there is a groundwater table, and maybe there are maybe vibrations that may be your due to natural conditions or due to some mechanical means, right? Because of that there is a settlement of your foundation. So you have to know the bearing capacity of soil, then stress distribution in your soil, then water conditions in your soil. All that you have to need to study. So the scope of soil engineering in foundation is very important. Now we'll see every civil engineering structure, whether it is building, bridge or dam, it is founded or below the earth surface. So the foundation is a required for every structure to transmit load of the structure in a soil safely and efficiently. Okay, now we will see first shallow foundation. Now what is mean by shallow foundation? You know what is mean by shallow foundation? Now the shallow foundation is generally the depth at which foundation is placed is less than its width. The depth, suppose this is your ground condition, I will mark here. Okay, this is your ground condition, right? And below that ground you have to set your foundation. Now the depth at which the foundation is placed, this is the depth of your foundation, all right? The depth at which foundation is placed is less than that's width. Width of foundation is your this. This is your width of foundation. Okay. Now the depth of foundation, if it is less than the width of foundation, then that type of foundation is called as a shallow foundation. Clear? This type of foundation spreads the load of superstructure. Superstructure means the structure above the ground, and substructure means the structure below the ground. This foundation spreads the load of superstructure into the ground laterally. Okay, and hence shallow foundations are generally known as a spread foundations also. Now in shallow foundation, depth to width ratio is unity or less than unity. Means suppose the depth of your foundation is 1 meter, then the width of foundation should be 1 meter or more than 1 meter. Okay, so the depth divided by width of foundation should be unity, 1 or less than 1. Means depth is always less than your width of foundation. Generally shallow foundations are called as a it is set in a 1.5 meter above the 1.5 meter depth from the ground level. Okay, now second one is your deep foundation. Now in deep foundation the depth at which foundation is placed is greater than its width. Depth of foundation at which the foundation is placed is greater than its width of foundation. Hence the depth and width ratio of foundation is generally greater than 4:5, means depth divided by your width, this ratio should be up to 4 and above the 4. Okay, so that is called as a depth foundation width, and pile foundation is one of the type of your depth foundation. Okay, the depth foundation distribute the load of superstructure into the ground vertically rather than laterally. We will provide the depth more than when your soil strata in the upper layer is very weak and loose, then we will prefer the deep foundation and we will prefer the pile foundation. Okay, where up to where you will get the hard strata, and we will raise the all piles on hard strata, so the superstructure load will be transferred to the hard strata in a vertical manner. So this is the shallow foundation and deep foundation, that is pile foundation. Then next one is your retaining structure. Now what is the scope of soil engineering retaining structure? Now when the sufficient space is not available for a mass of soil to spread, you know the nature of soil, when you just loose soil when you throw, then that soil will get spread due to its self weight. Okay, so the soil has nature to spread, and when there is not a sufficient space for a spreading, then we will do the covering for that soil, and that covering to protect the sliding of soil, that is called as a retaining structure for that soil. Okay, now when sufficient space is not available for a mass of soil to spread and from a safe slope, a structure is required to retain that soil, and earth retaining structure, okay, is also required to keep the soil at a different levels on its either side. Now there are different retaining structures. We will see, one is your retaining wall, that is earth retaining wall or RCC retaining wall, and second type is your sheet pile. Okay, now in retaining wall, see here, this is the retaining wall and this is the soil mass. We have provided the retaining wall for this soil so that the spreading of this soil will avoid it, and you will get the safe slope to retain this soil. Okay, and because of that, the soil will provide the earth pressure on this retaining wall. So to calculate this earth pressure, we know the geotechnical engineering here, the terms of geotechnical engineering, and due to this we will calculate the earth pressure, and after knowing the earth pressure and self weight of soil, we will design the retaining wall. So it is very important of soil engineering for civil engineering point of view. And the retaining structure may be rigid retaining wall or sheet pile, right, bulked, which is relatively flexible. Soil engineering gives the therefore the earth pressure on retaining wall. See here, sheet pile on a both side you will see the soil mass, right, this is ridge level and this is sheet pile, and here is also soil mass. To avoid this, to splitting of this soil, we will provide the sheet pile here. And when we will design the sheet pile, when we know the earth pressure from this soil on that sheet pile, then we will design the sheet piles. This is also one scope. The next one is your stability of slope. Now in stability of slope, there is a cutting and filling, two portions we will see. If the soil surface is not horizontal, there is a component of weight of soil which tends to move. I already told that soil has behavior of tends to move, right? It downwards and thus causes instability of slope, right? The slope may be natural or man-made. Now this figure shows the slope in filling and slope in cutting. Now the A figure is your slope in filling and B figure is your in slope in cutting. Means suppose you are making a highway. Now your highway will be safe only when your side slope of your embankment is safe, right? And to give the safety of that slope, we should know the geotechnical engineering, right? So that slope we will give by man-made only, man-made or by natural means, okay? And this is the figure. Figure B is your cutting. Now in cutting section, while making the highways on a guard section, we need to cut some portion, and after cutting the portion, we have to provide the slope on the cutting portion. Because of that, the side soil will not be collapsed or slides in a road section, right? And for that, we need to give the slope for that soil. So this is the slope for cutting. Okay. Now next is your underground structure. Now the design and construction of underground structure such as the tunnels, then shafts, then conduits requires evaluation of forces exerted by the soil on these structures. Now we are doing the tunnel in, then conduit in underground, right? Now after doing the tunnel or conduit or shafts in underground, the portion of soil or rock above that tunnel or conduit or shaft will give the pressure on that tunnel and on arches, and we should know that pressure so we can design the tunnel like that and it will sustain. So for that, geotechnical engineering is very essential. Now figure shows the diagram for tunnel, and the second one is your diagram for your conduit, right? Now shaft is your horizontal portion on your ground and conduit is your vertical section or vertical portion excavated in your ground. In tunnels you will see shafts and conduits. Then pavement design, we will see pavement design. Now in pavement design, a pavement is a hard crust placed on a soil. This is the total homogeneous structure of a different sections, means your sub base, then surface, like a sandwich structure. All are the homogeneous sections of different layers. So it is hard crust placed on a soil, that is on subgrade of soil, for the purpose of providing smooth and strong surface, right, on which vehicles can move easily. The pavement consists of surfacing, then base, then subbase, then bitumen layer, all the layers. And for that, we should know the soil engineering and properties of soil on which we are going to design the pavement. Then next one is your, last point is your earth dam. Now earthen dams are huge in structure in which soil is used as a construction material, right? Now the earth dams are built for creating water reservoirs. See here, this is the earthen dam made up of by soil only. Now this is your upstream side. Upstream side is that side of dam where the water is stored, and this is your downstream side where the you can spill your water, right? The failure of earthen dam may cause widespread catastrophe. Extreme care is taken in the design and construction is requires a thorough knowledge of soil engineering. If you have the thorough knowledge of soil engineering, then and then only where is the failure of earthen dam What are the causes of failure of earthen dam that we will get to know? Okay, so this is one section of earthen dam, and all these are the scopes of soil engineering in civil engineering point of view. With this, I will stop here. Thank you. If you have any doubt, then you can contact me or WhatsApp me anytime. I will clear it.